Hi, I'm Maurice Beinat. I'm Technical Director at ecoMaster. And today, I'm going to show you how to seal up a disused heating outlet like this one. Why would we want to do that? Well, most often it's because we're decommissioning the old gas ducted heating system. Maybe it's failed and it's a really good time to switch from gas to electric heating. So we'd be installing high efficiency split air conditioning systems to take over the heating and also provide some cooling if you need it. So when we're decommissioning a gas ducted heating system, we might be taking the furnace away and that will open the ducting to the outside air. Or even if we don't do that, over time the ducting's going to perish and fail under the floor, or it might be compromised by rodents. So what we want to do is seal the outlets to make sure that we're never going to have any draft coming through these outlets. Bear in mind that as well as all the outlets, we also need to seal the return air. You might know that as the really big duct. So most often it's in the floor somewhere out of the way, or maybe in its own little cupboard. Let's take a look now at what you're going to need in order to successfully seal up this heating outlet. These three components come in your kit. The first is the polyester insulation, and that's the anti-rodent part that goes in first. The foil board is the sealant part that goes in second, and the UltraClear is used to go around it to make sure that it's airtight and not going to move. Now, in order to use the UltraClear, you're going to need your own caulking gun. Remember, UltraClear is water-based, so if you happen to make a bit of a mess, just get a damp cloth and clean up with that. You're also going to need something to clean inside first. So I've got Isowipe alcohol wipes for that. You may not have that, that's okay. Just use a damp cloth and give a wipe around inside first. Remember, wait till it's dry before you proceed. Now, it may be necessary to cut the foil board, so you're going to need for that a measuring tape and a sharp long bladed knife. Now I've got this kind of knife with a very long blade, which is great. You may not have that, that's okay. If you've got a very sharp kitchen knife, that's going to do just as well.